And welcome back. This is KOTAL for the second map for HRE this Sunday, the 1st of October. First map we had Hooker's Push, which was a Union victory, pretty decisive one, off of a counterattack. Let's see how the Union does. This is another Union attack map. This is Bloody Lane, off of the Antietam map pack. We've got a 239 for the server pop. 116 for the CSA against 123 for the Union, so a little advantage for the Union there. Let's check out the teams. We have on the Union 1st USSS, 9th Corps, 4th New Jersey, HD, 6 AL, 88th New York,
6
New York, 10th US.
Bills
2 USC and 88th New York. I'm not sure if I mentioned those guys already, but that is it for the Union. They have no Arty on this map. Let's take a look at the CSA. We'll take a look at their Arty first and then end at the infantry. So for Bloody Lane, CSA Arty is back here in this orchard. Looks like they have a couple crews here. So they have 2 Corps. Looks like manning 2 guns under Sergeant Tomato Girl. And then we have LFL, it's like one gun under Captain Surflex. So let's take a look at CSA infantry. They have ANV, LFL, 13th Georgia, 20th Georgia, AB, Two Corps, along with SR, that's Targray, and JB. Miss anyone? Not believe so. So this is a tough defense map for the CSA. Usually, at least I've found, the point is along this little lane here, the sunken lane or bloody lane, depending on what you want to call it. As just a quick admin notes again for the HRE event, it starts at, it's live at 40. No charging and no bayonets until 30. I will leave a link to the description of the HRE event for anybody that might not be in the event that might have a unit that wants to participate. I highly recommend it. It's a lot of fun. And a little bit of rain here on the server. That will not frame rate too bad stream. With that, we are live. Let's see how the CSA will set up their defense. Alright, so initially they are going to send one unit out here as an advance guard, and that will be Captain Schumacher and the JV boys. Let's take a look at the rest of the team here. So besides Schumacher and his guys, looks like the rest of the CSA is all going to head to defend this right side against the Union. And this, to be honest with you, is my usually my default strategy. As simple as I am, I like to kind of come up on this right side and then see engagement go left. Let's see how the CSA defends and see how the Union attacks. Looks like the CSA is still getting set. They are doing a very advanced defense here. So JB is pulling its guys back. Maybe just a demonstration up there. Looks like the bulk of their forces are going to form up on this lane here. We've got LFL, the 2 Corps on the opposite side. Forward to them. We have, oh, Ninja's in here. Cool, he's joining with ANV under Killer. On the opposite side of the road here, we got Canada, 20th, on with 8 Georgia. Looks like AV's repositioning. I thought there was one unit forward. Looks like 13 Georgia did move forward, but they have been wiped out before I even got to see it. And here comes the Union down the hill, charging in against the CSA. Let's see how this engagement goes. And it is 88th New York Cav leading the way. They got hit pretty hard by that initial volley. It's like another element of the Union's coming in. Here comes HD. Let's see if they have better luck. There's no charging initially. So no bayonets. All you can do is club. And 6AL is here. They are in the open. CSA has good cover. They are taking some losses here. Oh, I like this. I like this a lot. So JB has moved up. Put some good flanking fire. Along with Kenner and his boys. So Union is in a kill box. So another unit coming in. 10th US trying their luck. Having a little bit more success. And A and B has pulled back after that initial engagement to their safety of their lines here, along with 2 Corps and LFL. While this is going on, though, the Union is repositioning its forces along the hill back here. Not all the action is going on down below. They've got 4th New Jersey up here. 4th New Jersey, I'm sorry. Pixel in command, putting some flanking fire on the CSA. And he is joined by 2nd USC. Who was commanding them? It's like Sluggy's in command again. So the Union has pulled back from that initial assault here. Ankle is taking the 6th New York and pulling him back a little bit. We got HD giving him some covering fire. After this initial engagement here, CSA is holding strong on this position here. 36 minutes remaining. Union took the worst of that engagement, about 50% down, battle ready. CSA about between a quarter and a third. So, nice setup by the CSA. Good layered defense. Good flanking fire. Union's gonna have to think of something to practice. Now, the left side of the CSA line is open. Don't really have anything covering it. Looks like the Union's gonna try going down the center lane. Or at least looking at it. Here is 88th New York trying to get a volley off. Only got 3 guys left. You guys are lasting longer than I thought they would. Oh, there they go. So Canada came up there with a pistol, finished it off. So the Union is now, though, spreading the field here a bit. With that demonstration there by the 88th New York, even though they lost, Union is taking this opportunity to move around the flank here. Here is Sluggy. There is one element guarding it, and it is 13th Georgia here. The CSA is reacting in time. So as 13th Georgia kind of watches the back door, JB has moved into the center here, kind of mirroring the Union advance. Is he alone? So far, he's the only unit that's moving off. But he's squaring off against a few. 13 Georgia and JB are squaring off against a couple Union units here. You got 10th US under Machado. You got Pixel with 4th New Jersey. And Sluggy here with 2 USC. So Sluggy will pick, get a base of fire here. Now 4th New Jersey here is moving up, chasing off 13th Georgia, establishing position on this right side. While that's going on, here comes Machado. And he is pushing off the JB. I don't think JB would have won that fight anyway. It's the 10th US has a lot of guys. They are pretty good, so I think that was the right call. They have less tickets on this map. They get back into a better position. While allies come up, and those allies are AB. And they will start putting some fire down here into 10th US. And that is under Captain Shovel. Hope I'm saying that right, brother. If I'm not, tell me I'm not. So let me know. 2 Corps is supporting. But the Union is capping now. They have a strong defensive line here with 2 USC, 4th New Jersey, and 10th US here on this fence. Meanwhile, the majority of the Union is still firing against the CSA against their defensive line there on the south side of the map. Compass will stop spinning. see if Union is going to go for an early cap, or they are just kind of trying to draw off the CSA here. Here's JB trying to find a flank. Just getting the volley off and getting back. They don't want to duke it out. AB has been heavily reduced in that fight. So let's take a look here on the CSA right here. This Bastion is still holding very strong. Got Killa here on the far right. Behind him is kind of the reserve. Of course, here we have LFL. Over to that, we have 20 of Georgia. To their left, we have 2 Corps. So a hell of a defensive line here that the CSA has set up. The Union has taken the left side of the field. And they are slowly capping. Meanwhile, let's see what the Union has. All right, they got HD out front. Behind them, they got Captain James from the 88th New York, along with 9th Corps, along this kind of side of the hill, side of the road. Besides them on the opposite side, they've got 6 AL and 88th under Hankel. I'm sorry, 88th is not under Hankel. 6 New York is under Hankel. Yeah, 6 New York. There's an 88th guy in there. My bad. To their right, kind of in the center of the battlefield, you got 1st U.S. sharpshooters doing some sharpshooting where they can. Distance shooting, good ones to them. To their right, you have 6 AL under Major Jackin. Looks like he is moving to support this flank. And then forward, we have, directly on the point, we have Colonel Machado, 10th U.S., 4th New Jersey under Pixel.
If they're lucky.
And watching the flank is the Cav, 2 USC under Sluggy. So a lot of communication going on right now. About even fight. 30 minutes, just about 30 left. Now at the 30-minute mark, the charging can begin and the bayonets can begin. So we'll see how that shifts the battlefield. Looks like the Union's pouring more units down here on this right side, getting ready to cap. M6AL has come to join them as reinforcements. 13 Georgia got hit pretty hard, but they are reforming. They're going to still try to watch the CSA flank, or at least put some fire, some pressure on the opposite side. Meanwhile, CSA is moving a lot more forces down here. Here comes 2 Corps, and they have support from AB. They're going to run into a hell of a Union force. Union is moving to cap. It is bayonet time. CSA charge up here? The CSA did charge up here. I like this, being aggressive. It was an initial charge I missed. I'm sorry I missed that, guys. Looks like 20 of Georgia went in. But now here comes Killer. He's going to clean it up. Although the Union will cap, CSA has now occupied the right side of this field. Has a very good shot at any Union reinforcements moving up. See where Killer goes from this new position. Meanwhile, we got a fight on the point. Looks like the Union has decided to charge in here on this left side. At least an element has. Union is now at engaged. Two Corps trying to shoot it out with the Union, but Union has a mass of their force here lined up on the point. They haven't capped yet, so they're not exactly on the point. They're just off of it, so good discipline by their guys. Not capping when they're not intending to. So. pretty much the entire Union forces along the source of the CSA is spread out, trying to find a flanket fire on them. There's some Union reinforcements coming in from spawn, but Killer is over there, and he's getting reinforcements, so they're going to have to decide if they want to deal with Killer or if they want to come down and help their buddies down here. So, nice attack by the CSA, creating a new promise for the Union. Out even on ticket. CSA already trying to find the Union there. So not easy shots, you don't have direct line of sight. So it looks like the Union has opted to bypass Killer and his element. Let's see who's with him. Well, not completely. So on this far side we have A and B along with 20 Georgia on the Canada. And they are tangling with Major Jockin and 6AL. Well, not really tangling with him. He's hiding behind the fence right now, so. But A and V does have blanket shots into the Union from distance. Not a bad positioning by him and his forces. But the Union does have a pretty strong position here. CSA already trying to stop him. Got 4th New Jersey here on the flank. As the CSA is crossing. It's an element of it. It is 13 Georgia trying to find a flank here. Union did see him. He didn't move to beat him, but here comes JB and Schumacher. Putting some more pressure there, but as that's going on, we got a flanking attack here by Killer. I imagine this is Killer. Yeah, it's Killer. And he is moving up, and he is going to intercept H. Jockin. If he is not careful, he will be ambushed.
Move left.
On the line.
Kind of a meeting engagement there. I think A&B got the better of it. But Union has seen A&B's move. Killer's not going to wait. He's going to try to knock out 6AL. And he's going to charge forward. Into the Union line here, who did react here. Ankle moved his guys up. As did Machado. They kind of caught A and B as they were charging up. They do have some support here on the far flank. The 20th Georgia. See if the Union decides to move up and try to deal with this element here. Which is a mixture of JB, 20th Georgia, and SR. They're still holding strong on there. Main fight there. Not easy for the CSA to push them off. Union is pushing up a bit here. As Killer and Canada decide to pull his guys back, trying to occupy their previous positions. Has reopened their line of communication here. Ankle here on that corner. Supported by Machado. 10th U.S. back here. Machado is moving his men up. Oh, they gotta be careful though. Here's a flanking force. Sluggy. 2 USC coming up. Kind of catching Killer here in his flank as he was trying to reorganize. As Machado moves up as well. Sluggy did get wiped though. Killer got the better of that engagement. Here comes 10th U.S. trying to cut off the CSA regiment here. Who's Canada? 20th Georgia here cut off by Machado. Nice flanking attack. has spawned. They have no retreat.
Hey, I'm not gonna...
Gil's gonna come in to try to help him though.
Sorry, loyalist. Very sorry. I love you. I love you. I'm very sorry. Table's one of ours.
US though. 6 New York. Henkel saw the attack. He flooded in as well.
Very good.
And that'll be it for that flank, although the CSA did dispatch a unit here. LFL, resecure the right side. Make sure the Union can't close that door as well. So they're going to try to hold this far right side now. Against the Union. So good redisposition there by the LFL to cover that back door. But they did lose some tickets there. So now, still holds that this side back here just off of. So far, the CSA has probed, I guess I'll call it, on this far left side. You got 2 Corps and 13 Georgia up here, but they have not been able to push up very far. CSA is almost at taking losses at 22 minutes. Union at engaged. About, say, either half, maybe 2/3 of the way down. At this point, though, I'd say the Union does have control of the field. CSA just trying to poke at this nation, this line here that's been established. Without losing too many of their tickets, that's the hard part. And here we are, as I'm saying it, CSA is now at taking losses, 21-20 left in the match. Union is at engaged. Let's see how they decide to reset their forces. Looks like they're going to reinforce this right side. Here comes Canada coming out of spawn. And JB Schumacher. He's going to come up and reinforce JB. Union, though, has not pushed too much. They got one element that's still watching this right side. It looks like the rest of the forces have reinforced in right. That will be 6 AL. CSA, though, looks like they are trying to find a flank here. 13 Georgia, but Union saw them. Oh, boy. HD. The Kurdath. Got the blood up. And HD doing good line discipline there, making sure the guys don't get overextended, along with, looks like Pixel was there, as long with First US. So good line disposition there, good line discipline, I would say. Holding that position and not kind of chasing off of a few Rambos. Take a look at the Union setup on this far left side. Looks like they're massing some troops over here. We got 9th Corps moving up, along with 10th US and Henkel with the 6th New York. Is there one more element? Nope, that's it. I don't know if they're going to try their luck here for a mass push against the CSA left. Just gonna shoot it out for a little bit. 19:35 left in the match. Alright, 9th Corps is going on the left side. Looks like Chino's moving back on the right. Still shootout back at point. Inconclusive. Trying to find this flank here. As Machado moving back into the center. CSA has moved up a bit. Bit of a more forward defensive position. JB.
Ready.
And some shots on the Union. Supported by LFL and 20th Georgia under Major Canada. There we go. I like the setup though. You got a forward line, reinforcing line. McKinnon are moving up on this corner here, getting some more shots on the unit. Machado has moved up, trying to find some more tickets here. Let's get out of the music's range. Could mute you, but yeah, he is getting some flanking fire on JB, while AB is putting some fire into his side. So looks like one CSA regiment did move up. I missed it. Was 20th Georgia. So Kenner, I mean, 20th Georgia under Major Kenner. But he is taking fire from the top of that road there. And there's Sergeant Major wisely is getting his men out of there. He was taking fire from Hankel in the 6th New York. So, 17:30 left in the match. We have CSA at taking losses. It's 88th is also moving up into the center now. CSA at taking losses. And at engaged, almost taking losses. Still, lines have been pretty steady, though. That 4th New Jersey here watching the back door. Actually, this is 13th Georgia looking for the flank again. No, it is 8th Georgia under Colonel Knight. It's incorrect in that assumption. He's getting some good flanking fire in. He's trying to poke the bear a little bit. Looks like the CSA has moved up again on this far right side. Let's see if I can catch this before it goes hot. And it is 13th Georgia came up on this side instead. And they are going to run into as I spin the camera around way too much there. 13th Georgia is going to mess around with 6th New York, but 6th New York is going to get the better of it. Chieftain Rollo. Last man alive. Hiding in the bush. You can't stop Major Roll. I guess you can. It's going to take a lot, though. And the CSA is almost at breaking. USA has just hit taking losses. And it looks like Chato is going to move his men a little bit closer to point. To make sure he is there to capitalize and cap when he wants to. He won this fight on this left side, but they still have LFL. Strong. Right, Georgia coming back up. Got JB and Schumacher there in the center, kind of reorganizing. Still have the shootout here on the left side. Kill it here with the A and V kind of being the anchor along with 2-4. They are exchanging fire with HD.
Just getting shot at.
Ordered. Along with 6AL and 88th New York and 2USC. Several units here all duking it out. Looks like the Union is. Nope. Chino's still putting some fire down to the CSA and their flanking force there. That was Canada, I believe, that moved up. No, it was JB. Canada's back here giving support. Union is coming down the road. Here comes the Union force. And with that attack by the Union on this flank, CSA has been pushed on the breaking. That attack was done by 9th Corps, along with 6th New York, supported by Machado, put in flanking fire. But with that, positioning his men there, along with the rest of the unit here holding strong, they have moved up to cap. I get the camera right here. Here comes the CSA trying to push him off a bit. USA is going to flood troops in. But they got a bit of a distance based on how they were set up. Union has a strong line already built here. And I think it would be too much. And that will be it. Tough match for the CSA. They were aggressive. I like to see it. They really good attacks out on the flanks several times. But the Union reacted well, was able to secure them again, keep pressure. But the big thing I think that contributed to the win was taking the Union right side by that initial element and just holding it strong, but then having those elements like 10th U.S. that could flex where they needed them to go and put down and being positioned. So when they did finally get the CSA down to breaking, they could cap and not having poor discipline in capping before they won it. So another win for the Union. Strong performance from both teams, but got the better of them. Fun to watch. Make sure you guys let me check it out. Let's take a look at what we have for casualties. Excuse me. We got for the CSA 517, for the Union 560. So another fun weekend. I hope you guys have a good week. That will be all from me. Have a good one.